أعزائي المشاهدين، أهلا وسهلا بكم من جديد مع برنامجكم الأسبوعي برنامج إماراتي. كما عودناكم بكل أسبوع نستضيف لكم خيرة من دولة الإمارات قصة نجاح أتتنا إلى الدولة منذ 33 عاما. مستر مير، good afternoon.
Hello, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you so much. We are so lucky to be here with you in your company. Our team said you would come in our program.
We appreciate it, no problem. You're most welcome.
And you would like to know about yourself. Who's Mr. Mir when he comes to this country at the first time and what he's doing at this moment?
Hi, this is Mir Mujtaba. Sitting in front of you and talking with Emirati TV today. As you asked me a question, that I landed up in this country on 3rd of March in 1990, where Dubai is not what Dubai was when I landed up in Dubai.
Talking about the person who finishes engineering education and come to this country to find a job or opportunity in the company that they invite him from his country, right?
That's true. Basically, I've been working for one of the biggest organizations of my home country in India, the biggest engineering group called Larsen & Toubro. I left that and I came into Dubai with an opportunity to work in the international market, because my passion has been, I've been a very technical person and I wanted to be commercial expert along with the technical knowledge which I had, and that's what motivated me to move from my country to land up in the international market.
The mechanical engineer who comes to this country and he stays as an employee for 12 years, he takes the decision to go through metal. He didn't going through construction or marine. Why?
Yeah, my engineering has been in mechanical, so I have nothing to do with civil or marine or anything. It's been a mechanical engineering, and my specialization has been in reclamation in my engineering time. And my expertise has been in reclamation and how to really have a good recycling method in the metal industry. So that's how I have continued in recycling.
Talking about 2002.
Yep.
2002, it was a big booming in Dubai.
Yep.
This booming, this make opportunity for everyone, and for sure, the section of metal or recycling, nobody focusing on it that time.
True.
So, you was alone in the market or there is other people?
No. I have been in this industry, like I said, for about 33 years now. I've been an employee with a very big recycling group when I started, and in 2002 I left that group and started my own office. And we started as a very small agent with one man show and just my wife coming and supporting me with filing and cleaning and all. And today you can see how and what level we have really reached, and we thank this land basically, which has made such a safe haven for us to have a good business opportunity started, and we have been successful in this business.
Mr. Mir, when you opened this company or the recycling company, you was no or sure that the profit it will not be that much, so that's why you start other activity as a restaurant.
No, that was only a passion and for a time pass, and I'm a foodie, you know, so that's how I made this restaurants to run, but this has nothing to do with my day-to-day life, and I don't really visit my restaurants or anything every day on day-to-day basis. My main aim is in the recycling industry, and my main time spent is in the recycling industry.
Maybe we don't see many people, their passion, that's to save this earth. So, who built this mentality in your craft?
See, to be very honest, the recycling itself is so passionable for me. It's my passion to do something for the Mother Earth. And it's really proving well. And today we have a small members, not in association, a company where all the recyclers are there together, and I happen to be the president of that organization called Bureau of Middle East Recycling, And my passion is what is there for recycling to save the earth for tomorrow.
If from 100 person there is one person who will take care of earth, the earth should be totally green. You are agree with me?
100%, yes, definitely. And I don't want one person out of 100. I want at least 100 people out of 100. At least 100 out of 100 to contribute something for the Mother Earth, what they can do, the best. If not anything, just plow a small tree. Just don't use too many of tissues. Just see how best you can switch off your lights. All these do contribute to save the Mother Earth for tomorrow.
Corona makes a dream for you?
Corona, yes. Corona has really given a big break for all of us, basically. And I think one way is, yes, it was very destructive for all the humanity. But I think, yes, indirectly, there was less pollution in the world during that time, I think.
Yes, the earth, he take the refresh.
Yes, it is.
The corona did what the human cannot do.
That's right. So, but it was not a good sign for all of us. Not a good sign. Everybody suffered in the, during that time, you know very well.
But let's see the good corona.
I will not. I will not see that as a positivity when I see on the humanity grounds and what disasters we have gone under. No, I will not see that as a positivity. But yes, as a Mother Earth, the pollution was less. Trees were cut down very less. People stayed in their homes. All these things have contributed, yes.
Also wasting, no?
Yeah, it's not wasting. I think if you take positivity side, then they were more with their families. They spent real time with their families. Me, in person, I spent more time in my life during Corona with my family than any other time.
When we talk about recycling section and talking about what the activity we can, we talk about metal. And metal, we can go to the many parts, from copper to iron to ferrous. We can talk about zinc. So did you specialize in special metals?
I am most specialized in non-ferrous metals like copper, aluminium, zinc, stainless steel, lead. And this is my specialization in recycling. And I don't do much in ferrous. Like the iron recycling and all, we don't do much in this. My specialization is from the starting. What I went into depth is basically non-ferrous only.
And what kind of recycling you do for this material?
See, basically we are traders and agents, and also in future we will be manufacturing with recycling material. And we are supportive with our associated yards to supply the right quality product to the real smelters who make recycling products.
And this all inside this country, or you export out?
Not necessary. Some is there inside this country, and mostly it's exported. But if you see the ratio today, what it was yesteryears is not there today. Earlier, everything 100% was an export, but today no, 100% is not exported. We are seeing good industrial growths here. We are seeing good industrial industries being built up over here, and recycling is taking a good message among the community here. And I see in future, in the next 10 years, I don't think so there will be any exports from here in recycling. And all the material will be recycled here, and the message of sustainability and COP28 given by our leaders, and especially our president and the vice president, is going to go very strong among the community here.
We believe in our president because always they are say and they do.
Yes.
And they mentioned for us it will be sustainable city during until 2045.
I think they will surely achieve before the time. With the time, with the plan, with the money and all what our leaders are doing it, I think it will be much before 2040, I'm saying.
As an end user, our normal person, how he can survive this earth?
In which way?
Normal person.
Normal person, in fact, if really he wants to contribute towards the earth, the best way is it starts from the house. You should do it in from the house. I'm sure everybody likes to have a soft drink of a Pepsi or a Coke or something. Such when you take a drink, My message is that please don't throw the can in the dustbin, in the garbage. You can collect it separately, because that is the message of sustainability. It starts with you. It starts within you. And my message is there also to the children, you know, when they start growing, be it in the schools or at home. In fact, they have to be really getting the knowledge of what is to be placed where and how. If you want to survive for future generations, if you want this earth to be good enough for future generations, recycling is the message which I can give.
Mr. Mir, we are here because you are one of the best. So when we talk about Emirati program, he choose always the people who reach to the river. That we are so proud with it. That remind us with the word of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed that mentioned, it's hard to be number one, but the hardest to stay on the same level. How we can be always in the top and never go any step back in our business life?
See, I will not say that I'm the best, but one thing is, I can always say that I'm one among the best techno-commercial people available in this country with regard to our own business, that is recycling business. I have no knowledge about, if you ask me any other business like electronics or textile or anything, no. My message is very clear. I always use my tagline, recycling will save the earth for tomorrow. And we have to give our message very clearly to everybody that in this world, if you really want to see a blue sky all the time and not a gray sky, recycling is the message for you. Otherwise, the future generation will ask, what is the color of the sky? They should not say gray, they should say blue. And recycling and sustainability is the only message which we can pass on for our future generation.
Mr. Mir, we know you have a fair enough knowledge about all kind of recycling.
Yeah.
And you have many strategies.
Yeah.
So, do you have any idea that we can offer it for DDA, for example, for the construction company, that they can reduce it?
See, most of the companies now are very, very knowledgeable and they're very well aware, be it construction or even any company, they all, whatever the leftover is there, they bring it to the right place of recycling now. So recyclers collect material from any industry, any workplace, anything which is available, they do collect and they bring it.
And it can be this recycling material be in our furniture again?
Furniture? I think mostly yes, recycling material is furniture, what is getting broken down and all, they are now definitely going in for recycling.
Green community, planet tree, this yeah. is your vision also.
Planting of tree has always been a passion for me. And the best way to contribute some, like a common man, the best way he can contribute towards the planet is plant a tree and show the world that we are green.
Dubai always support any green, any sustainable project. Even if you want to open a license under sustainable, your cost it will be less responsibility. Did you try to get this idea for or give this idea for responsibility that to survive all you need?
Hats off to the municipality, the way they do the job over here. Nobody could really believe when I landed in Dubai from those days when everybody in India was saying you're going to a desert where you'll see nothing. When I landed up and I saw everything was green over here, the roads, the parks and the pathways where I saw the green, that really motivated me, and I'm sure Dubai municipality is doing a great job on this.
The area that you stand and there is one tree in all the desert.
Yeah.
Now, how many trees there?
The reason why, if you're talking about what you're referring to, one of my videos of one tree, that message is not to say how many trees are there today. I went into such a place, I had to search for a single tree in a desert. And I had to really do the hard work of going and searching for a single tree in a desert is only to convey a message that let's not work or let's not really live in a planet like how a desert is with no trees. Let us all live in a beautiful place like what we are here today and plant more trees. That was my basic message, and tree plantation has always been a good success within us.
The vision of Mr. Mir, or the spotlight that he always focusing where?
On the recycling only. Mm-hmm. Only recycling. My most of the time is towards, in fact, I do have my own business to run, but most of the time I try to educate people even on what recycling is. And I salute the rag pickers all around the world. Definitely it's not a very professional way they do it, but they are the real recyclers and they are the ones who really save the earth and they are the ones who bring in sustainability. The people who go and pick up the real recycling material from the garbage bins which is placed all around the world. So I salute those people and all my credit goes to that lower level people who really contribute for what we are today.
If we are at the end of this year and we ask you to give a message for all the people who sit in COP28, what you would say?
First of all, I would like to really give a salute to my leaders over here, be it from the president to our vice president. COP28 coming in UAE is not something very small. And a small country like UAE landing up with such huge events and nothing can be better. We are proud with our leaders and we always have best wishes and prayers for the best living and a long life, you know. They have made, I think, more than 200 nationalities a safe haven over here in UAE. And what else can you have? The best living, the best place, the most safest place, and enjoying all the benefits of your life. What else do you need? So that's one message is COP28 is going to prove that we are in UAE number one reaching in the world.
If I will ask you about how many hours behind me, we will not finish the interview. But tell me about the best award that you get it in your life.
Best?
Award that you awarded.
No, these are basically awards which come, I think, every day. So most of the places wherever I go, maybe to give a lecture, to give a message, they do appreciate with giving an award or a plug. But I have a long journey to go still. These awards are not going to really go so fast, but I have a very long journey to go on recycling. And we will prove that recycling is going to be the future business hub of our country too.
Do you think this 12 days in COP28, it will affect the world as big as what they are thinking?
I think it's the heads of states which are going to decide. We are too small for it. But only way we can contribute is that whatever the message is going to come from our leaders, we just try to follow that.
Sustainable city, it will be done, inshallah, before 2040, right?
I'm sure about that, yes.
So
it's not only for sustainable city. Everybody will have the knowledge of sustainability. That's more important. And I think over here, everybody will wake up and definitely contribute towards whatever the plan of our leaders are.
Mr. Mir, I don't agree that all the people have knowledge fair enough that what is the mean of sustainability, what's the mean of really recycling. They're not just headline.
I think so, yes, definitely, yes.
How we can build this knowledge in these people here?
To be honest, we have concentrated on some schools also. We as a team go to schools, we teach the children, we convey a message to the children that what sustainability, what recycling and how a daily life can contribute for a better and a greener earth for tomorrow. And we have visited quite a lot of schools and to be honest, we have participated in during our recycling conferences or recycling programs of Bureau of Middle East Recycling, BMR. We have invited schools to come and give a short play over there. And last year, we had one of the best plays of what recycling industry is by one of the schools in Abu Dhabi. They joined us and the kids from 3 years to 8 years, they have really a better knowledge than, yes, what a common man can have because they are now going in for this learning. And I think the best place for everybody to know what is recycling or sustainability or how to save the Mother Earth or the planet, the best is that we have to really teach in the academic schools itself from these starting ages.
If we ask Mr. Mayor to be one of the speakers in Innovation Summit in Portrait Center, you would agree?
I don't mind it on any subject. With regard to recycling, I'm always available.
Even if you are tired, and now you are tired also, you make...
No, it's not I'm tired of anything. It's just that I'm not been keeping that well, that's all. I'm not tired. But when it comes to recycling, I think even if I have a good fever or anything and everybody talks on recycling, like my wife says very easily, that you are made of metals, you are made of recycling materials or what. Whenever you talk on any recycling, anybody talks, you are very fresh and fine. And when you come at home and you sit like you are a tired man. So it's better we all start talking on recycling, you'll be fresh in your life. So,
but you are agree also that behind the businesswoman or the one who refreshes Patri, the wife, right?
My family, my wife has been good support for me, no doubt in that. My family has been really very supportive. And wherever we go, in and around the world, the eye is more than seeing what the world is with good monuments and all. We see how the vehicles are moving around with recycling material, how many trees are there. This is what is our passion. And we try to take pictures and whatever. We have a lot of data with us with regard to how recycling is.
You built these things in your wife, or already it was before you meet her?
No. My wife is a pure housewife, and she supported me in recycling industry. But today, yes, she also has the knowledge of what and which metal is in recycling.
Where do you see yourself after 5 years?
If God wishes, if we have a good life in future, I think I don't see a big position or what or something. I think wherever I'm sitting right now, today I own my own company, and I'm the founder president of an organization called Bureau of Middle East Recycling. We have a very big conference coming up on 20 and 21 of October 2023, and we are seeing a lot of delegates coming in from United States to Japan, from Australia to Russia, to come and participate on the message of how important recycling is. And definitely we want to convey the message over there, how important COP28 is coming up over here in UAE. And that is really a moment of pride for recyclers.
Is there any AI or any new technology coming after this digital age?
I don't see anything right now in the recycling industry other than the machinery coming up in the future. The machinery for processing recycling material will add up with AI, and still I think human knowledge is very important in that.
Why our engineer didn't try to make his own machinery?
That's not my expertise, no. Machinery, everything cannot be done by one person. Everybody has their own share to do. But I'm very proud to say that there is no major recycling hub or a factory in most of the part of the world which I have not visited and seen it, just to gain knowledge about it. And we have worked very closely with big aluminium can manufacturers. And working on recycling is more of my passion than building up a machinery or something like this, you know.
Yes. UAE is a hub, or Dubai is a hub for everyone. Many people come into this country as an investor or employee, or even people come for tourism only. So also these people need an advice from the people who have fair enough experience in this country, same like you, Mr. Mayor. What the first advice you give it for this newcomer here?
First of all, I will first talk about myself. Dubai, or if you say UAE as a nation, has given success to most of the people who have landed up over here. And that's the best part of this country. The land over here has given more of success, and I've almost not seen any failure over here who have really come here worked dedicatedly and worked on the terms and laws of this country. And I can only say that I can only wish them, when they come here, bring in knowledge, bring in money. This is a safe land for you to be in Dubai.
Mr. Earth Lover.
Yep.
What you will say for your wife who was in this camera?
Keep continuing to do a good job, like you have been partnering with me in recycling. And to be honest, in my house we have planted many trees in and around. We have more trees and more of birds and all kept in our house. So she's also a nature's lover. So one of the attractions is there that she also loves nature and I love her. So that means nature is automatically coming to my line also.
Yes. Finally, this country, which give us opportunity, but give us many things we cannot find it over the world. The main thing is the peace and safe country that we
yes.
cannot compare it with any
yes.
other country. Starting from His Highness Sheikh Zayed, the first step, some Zayed, they make it number one in the world. What you say for your leaders and government for this opportunity?
To be honest to you, personally from my side, on behalf of my family, like I said, I always salute the leaders of UAE. I'd like to thank them for giving such a safe haven land and for us to live. More than 200 nationalities living together with harmony and without racism is the best part in this part of the world, what I can see. And I only would like to end up my talk by saying a few words of blessings and prayers to our leaders of UAE. Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed or Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid, especially, who has been a man of visionary for me. And I would really like him to live a very long life, because what he has given in Dubai for us, nobody else in this world can really afford to give. Thank you once again for all this what you have done for me too. Thank you.
Mr. Mir, from our side, we are so proud, and not we, all the earth, proud of you, because you are the soldier of this earth. So inshallah we will be sustainable and we will be green.
Thank you very much. And in fact, there are many videos on the earth and recycling which I've tried to make, and still I'm going to make in the future quite a lot of clips which will come for 30 seconds, 45 seconds or 1 minute.
And the root channel name?
No, it's just Mir Mushtaba. My own name, sir. Yeah, I just produce it. Whenever I find a new idea within myself on recycling, I stop and I do it. And recently, I made a very good movie, a small clip of 30 seconds. I was in one of the Indian jungles. We were passing by going to another city, and it was a jungle, and I had to stop in between my car. Gordon went inside the trees, even though it was very scary. It was a tiger sanctuary is there, but I had to stand there and take some pictures of nature and how important trees look like and how beautiful the world looks with green. في كل إمارة تروح تسلد كعقل وروح بر ومدن وجبال حاجة تريد